Then it might be messy for those involved.
There we go. Hey, everybody. Welcome to AV Epics Livestream. I'm Dan Stacey, and you are about to witness my nerdy family and I use silly voices and exploding dice because we are playing an open legend tonight, Fallout Fort Smith. We were waiting on... Oh, Moustache. I had to rearrange windows suddenly, so I'm going to fix that now.
Yeah, I noticed that. There's two of me, and now my head's cut off.
Yeah, unbelievable. Let's see if this works. Hey, it's working now.
Yeah, OBS was like having a hissy fit.
Yeah, I was having a hissy fit here. But we got this. Snap cameras there.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, hey, Mom. Welcome. I'm very excited to see one of our supporters, Brian. How are you, Brian?
Hey, Brian.
See you in the chat. Hopefully everyone who was waiting in the other stream made it over here. I'm so sorry about that. OBS just gave up the ghost.
Yeah, I need to bring up the new chat.
Here we are. So, anyways, let's do some introductions, and then we will get into this game. We may have one other person join us, waiting to see what's going on with that. But otherwise, so if that happens, the windows are going to get all messed up. I'll fix it. Fear not. Otherwise, we'll just keep going. I'll make Moustache and Chris and I bigger. So, announcements for Avenue Studios. Special things are end of this month, October 29th. We're having a special movie night for Halloween. We watch Over the Garden Wall, and this time Adam from the Inn Of Planar Crossroads will be joining us in person. We're actually going to have a ton of people from Avenue Studios physically in the garage studio watching it, so it's going to be really fun. We might live stream a little before that for everyone to get a sense of what movie night's our like for our patrons and local subscribers. So if you want to join in that movie night and join our patron or our locals community, and you will get access to not only our Discord, but movie nights, games like this. You could join in on live streams like this as well, and a whole lot of fun. And I think that's about it. Of course, when we hit our goal, I think we need 4 or 5 more supporters, and we will unlock the Kanaga movie night, where we'll watch my college thesis film that stars a lot of people from Avenue Studios now, about 15 years younger. So it's going to be really great. So I think that's about it. I will turn it over to, we'll start with Adam and then and see what announcements are over at the IOPC.
Well, there's the one that you're talking about. We're going to be visiting you again. Now, I can't promise to be doing this every year, but we're going up twice this year because we needed to finish that storyline.
So yes. That's
why we had to do it this time. But the plan is to be there, and I'm going to bring some stuff to make popcorn and my red hot apple cider.
So. Nice.
Ooh.
And I've spent chocolate chip cookies over here, so.
Yes, Kristen's chocolate chip cookies.
See, I always tell them, you know, the food doesn't exist unless I've tasted it. So there, those chocolate chip cookies.
They're good.
But as far as other announcements, I don't think we've got much with that. November is going to bring the end of the final videos for the Adventure Academia that's been recorded. And also, it's going to bring some discussion in November on... we're recording it this Saturday about... Let me see. You don't have to have epic levels to tell epic stories, or something along that line. So that's what we'll be discussing this coming Saturday. And that will be out in November also. So... That is a plan. That's all I've really got. I'll be doing a new giveaway announcement later at the end of the year when I do the end of the year update, and it will have the goal that we need to reach for that giveaway to happen. So
awesome. Woohoo! I'm excited for all of it. Moustache, good sir. Anything going on with Open Legend in particular, or anything you'd like
Nothing
to shout out?
Nothing that I can announce yet.
Okay.
Still a lot of things in the works, so... hopefully with some of my travel schedule changing, that'll help free up a little bit of time. I got to get some quotes from artists, so
that's exciting.
Yeah,
awesome. All right, well, if announcements are out of the way, let's dive into Fallout Fort Smith. Take us away, right, Adam.
So as you hear, atom bomb, baby little atom bomb, I want her in my wigwam. And it starts to play. And we come in from not a green cloud, but definitely one that could have been tinted that way had it had just a little more of the river that you see below you been in view. We come into this aerial shot coming through that fog that's now coming up and evaporating away from the Damned 13. The Damned 13 being a lock and dam that is now overgrown with huge mushrooms that have grown large and massive from the radiation. And we come west, following broken roads and destroyed homes and houses, through the different things, seeing mute hounds and other aberrations and buzzing things that are well known to Fallout players, weaving in between the streets and around, coming down an interstate until we see the end of the interstate, and razor grain fields spread out far and wide. Strange roar and growl over the fields, and then turning back, finally coming and stopping, and a view of a now very small caravan of a couple ghouls, a rather large robot and their, I guess it would be a converted, perhaps a converted atomic vehicle at one point, but now just drug along as a kind of wagon.
I love that.
I'll leave you guys to flavor that. And as that Atom Bomb Baby music starts to fade out in this intro, the batteries start to go out in your last set of batteries that fit that radio that you had with you start to go out as the radio's announcer starts to come on and say, thanks for listening to Atom Bomb Baby from Atom Bomb. Now, Nathan Stop is...
Man.
I told you to bring more batteries.
I thought I told you to bring more batteries.
It's not my job. I do shooting, you get the stuff.
Well, yes, we're almost here.
Sirs, the music has stopped.
Thanks. Thank you. Well, I guess we should unload. Should we head to the bar?
Yeah. I'll wet my whistle a little bit.
Is there something to shoot nearby?
Well, I hear in the soundtrack that's playing some cawing. You guys are coming up to set it for everybody, and there is a free map for you guys to follow along. If you go to either one of our Discords, you can find that map. Or if you go to the Inn Of Planar Crossroads Twitter account, you can find it too, and Facebook, I think. Okay. But it was shared a long time ago. It is the locations for Fallout Fort Smith, and you players are coming up right around T, which is representative on the map of Cisterna Settlement. It is the southernmost settlement on the map. It is halfway up a hill. There used to be quite a bit of what looked like nice houses to the right, to the west of y'all. And as you're coming up and along that, you have spotted those different things that were there. Unfortunately, those are not there anymore, or at least not completely. The settlement itself looks like it is starting to build itself up. It is one of the newer portions of Fallout Fort Smith, but it is also... as much as you can thrive, it seems to be kind of thriving a little bit in this southern portion of this particular part of the map. So.
You look good.
Thanks. I think the sun does me good.
What do you look like?
What I look like? Your typical ghoul woman. So she's probably, you know, lost most of her hair. So she's got like these long little strand pieces. Because if you don't know, a ghoul is somebody who has had so much radiation kind of that they like changed. And so they look radiated, I guess you would say. Like their skin is like leathery and kind of burned off-ish looking. And... so she's lost most of her hair, but she's got these long strand pieces that, you know, one's got like maybe a little bow on the end of that she's kind of tried to braid.
Nice.
so she likes to try to make herself look as good as she can. But yeah, I figured traveling clothes, pretty dirty, pretty rugged. And I think of her as having maybe a hat on too, maybe like a cowboyish kind of style hat.
Nice.
Sometimes she wears it, sometimes it's hooked onto her belt. So I think at the moment it's on her belt. So
awesome. My character, Colton.
I'm Wendy. Sorry.
Hi. I know who you are.
My character, Colton, is totally bald, and he's got a lot of muscle showing through his skin on his arms and probably his legs, but he's always wearing thick pants, and he's got this apron on. Work apron, leather thick, and it's got pockets, and it's always jingling with tools, and he looks really happy for a ghoul. Even the only thing that's off-putting other than the gnarled face is no nose there, but he'll always just be smiling and looking around, and his eyes just are forever bloodshot. And we have a little robo dog too that's running around barking. Mm-hmm. And
Dodger.
Then there's the answer.
Yeah, the answer is a sentry bot. he's a prototype liquidator sentry bot Mark 42. And got, you know, pretty big base, three legs. I say legs, they're extensions. Of course, got the various wheels for moving around and stuff. Torso that can fully turn 360 with giant Gatling guns for the hands. And a large mortar shell on, or not shell, large mortar gun on the back. The head, unlike most sentry guns, since he's a prototype here, has got a head that can actually kind of move a little bit, kind of like what my avatar currently looks like on the screen. So it took some power armor head and put it in place there.
Awesome.
To make interfacing a little bit different with people. they had a merged coding language with a Mr. Handy while they were in prototype mode so that they could better analyze things, but that was never removed, so.
That's what happens when you, as I typed in the chat before, that's what happens when you mix pre-war programming languages, one from Robco and one from General Atomics. It just doesn't work.
I love it.
All right. And then your wagon is something. So what do you think?
Yeah, I like the idea of it being some kind of armored vehicle at once, but like the front half is broken off. And we just kind of hook it up to the answer. Just this little...
Yeah, the answer just tows it along.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if he even notices.
All right.
And how far away are we from the actual settlement right now? We can see it in the distance, but are we like 50 feet from it, like a mile away?
From Cisterna settlement?
Yes.
You guys are within sight of Cisterna settlement. As far as you can tell, it's a safe shot. There's nothing in your way right now. So you can, as far as you can tell, get up there and get to Cisterna settlement and have no problems at the moment.
And there's birds flying overhead, you said?
Yeah. We'll say there's some birds.
Yeah. I want to take a shot.
Okay. You, yeah, you can try. You can certainly try.
So it's normally this, and then do I get
you're one? Rolling 2d10 advantage one.
D10?
Yeah, because you have martial focus.
Oh, okay.
So
2d10. Advantage 10. One. Yeah. Got it. Mm-hmm. Real dice, peep. Okay. 19.
That's not bad.
19?
Yeah.
Her d20 okay, still doesn't so, like her.
It's okay. We'll get better.
So, let's see then. You take a pot shot at... It's a big seagull.
Albatross. So big
as a, I don't know. No, actually, looking through your scope, they look like they're real far away, but you kind of take a shot anyway, and you realize there's about three of them, and they were buzzards, or they look like buzzards from where you are.
Oh.
And they keep... You definitely know that they noticed you, and you kind of guess, oh, kind of maybe... I saw some feathers fly, but they didn't stop flying. And they kind of get a little bigger as they come, as it starts to wheel around you.
Uh-oh.
Well, also, like...
A little bigger.
The moment that the shot was taken, the answer immediately, like, widens out their base and lowers down, and the Gatling guns come up.
Warning, okay. Warning. Fire detected.
Oh, no.
Danger. Danger.
You gotta warn him when you're gonna shoot.
I'm sorry. Can I take out my mini binoculars to see what that is coming down? Are they really just birds?
There's about three of them. And sure, you're whipping your eyes out real quick. Not literally, since you're cool.
I really could.
So, by the time you get your eyes out, they've come down quite a bit further. They are indeed buzzards, but they are not very kind-looking ones. Unfortunately, you attracted the attention of some rather large buzzards that look, that have, instead of red heads, have black heads, and their feathers. They almost themselves look like they've got a little ghoulishness to them. And that's not something that you've probably seen in a few other species around. But they're deciding to come down and see what's all this fuss about somebody visits. So I guess we're rolling initiative already.
Yeah, I was about to say, I'm guessing the dancer has noticed this.
Yes. So let's go ahead and do initiatives.
Oh,
that's a good
man.
Job, Wendy. Good job.
Gotta shoot the birds.
It's the post-apocalypse, yo. Yeah. If you're taking pot shots at stuff, I'm just saying.
Am I still a dice pool higher when I'm...
No, that's only for shooting.
Okay, that's only for shooting. Okay, got it.
Got a 15 for initiative.
Okay.
Ooh.
Nice.
I exploded on both my eights.
Oh, nice, girl.
But math.
How far away are they right now?
They are coming. Let me see. Your firing range is quite far, but I'm not sure you would want it. I'm not sure how the mortar would hit them.
Oh, I don't know if I... Well, I could try and use the mortar, but yeah, making it explode in the air.
Just feathers.
That might be hard to time, yeah.
Yeah. I was just thinking for my Gatlings, too, because I got 150 default range because of long shot.
Yeah, they're probably within one movement of that, of getting to y'all.
Because I can go to, like, 450, too, just with disadvantage.
Okie dokie.
Okay. I got three.
you're too busy going back and forth between your wife and the answer.
Everybody keeps shouting.
Oh, yeah. Do you need to roll initiative for your companion? Or?
Oh, I was going to... Do you want him to just act on my turn, or do you want me to roll separate for him?
What are you going to have him... Is he like a combat actor, or is he more of a support actor?
He is... He will defend Wendy. So if...
We can just...
Yeah. So he is more combat...
Because he has the companion feat.
Yeah. I have the companion feat. Thank you. So, but yeah, all he'll do is basically if anything gets too close to Wendy, he's going to attack it.
Okay. It is your choice then. You can have him go on his own or you can run him on yours, whichever's more convenient for you then.
Okay.
Does he have higher initiative?
Yeah, I'll have him. I'll roll for him. Do you have Dodger?
Okay. It's kind of hard to not get higher than three.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got a DA.
1d8. This is advantage too. No?
Is
that right?
Well, he's not biting. That would only be if he's biting. Okay. Well, 10.
All right.
A hot dice tonight.
I'm actually rolling okay.
I'll take it.
All right. What was Wendy's again?
32, I think. Yeah.
32. A lot.
Axe.
All right. B and
see if I got a little.
Let's see. All right. Well, I guess that means that swooping down upon everyone is three kind of weird, ghoulish-looking buzzards. Some strange kind of thing going on with them. Big ones! So, initiatives have been rolled. Wendy gets first shot. Everybody's ready. No surprise or anything like that. Mm-hmm. So, let's get started.
Let's do this!
Yeah. Wendy's gotta have her trusty Darlene out, and she's going to take a deep breath, get into her zone for aiming, and then she's going to try to take the closest one out.
Okay.
Hopefully.
Closest one is... Okay, I know which one's closest. Gotcha.
Is it two advantage with battle dress? Yeah. Right?
Yep.
Yeah.
2d10. And then you have advantage one on the attack.
Got it. Okay.
So 3d10 total.
Got it.
Did you focus action?
I just took a deep breath and focused, yeah. I guess.
Do you want to sacrifice minor and move to do a focus action attack?
Oh, sure.
Okay, then you can do four. So she's going to focus action attack. Two highest.
Also, another good question is how many legend points do we have starting off with?
Oh, that's a good question.
I'm only giving y'all one legend point each. Until y'all earn some more in this,
because
I know better than to give legend points out before people start doing stuff.
So 20, not now. No.
20, but
a
not
dirty
now.
20.
Okay, let me check. Dirty 20. All right, that's definitely enough with these things. You take that shot in, and that deep breath seemed to make a difference, but you can tell as it hits. These things don't seem to be particularly robust, but they are not friendly, and you've definitely hit that one for a good amount. It starts to flop and flutter in the air, so that is a good shot on it. I'll mark it down. Damn it, what was the result again? 20.
That's 20.
The
result. Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, we are to the answer. What you want to do, Mr. Gatling Guns?
So the answer raises the Gatling Guns, got the perfect aim in to do a 20-foot line shot of Gatling Blast at this thing, and starts to speak.
Colton, Wendy, be errant.
Oh my, what's going on? Oh my, we are being attacked. We should run. Do you have your tea, sir? Do you have your tea, sir? And he starts to try it. So he moves 30 feet forward as the Mr. Handy comes into play, and he forgets that he is a sentry bot as my flaw mood disorder comes in, and he just moves forward 30 feet instead of taking the shot on these things.
Oh. Beautiful.
Where are you going? He's doing the thing again. I can't get him.
Colton's already running.
You got my wagon.
I'm going to throw running dog.
Fair enough. All right. So, you start moving farther ahead. That means now we are to the first one. This is the one that Wendy hit. It circles around a bit, and it sees you trying to move away. So, fluttering as it does, it kind of gets over about where you are, and it is going to try and do something to... Let me see. I guess it knows who shot it. So it's going to try and puke. It's going to try and puke on Wendy.
Oh, good.
Well, I guess the other question, do you guys ride on the cart, quote unquote cart,
no,
or were you walking beside it?
I imagine that we walk.
Yeah, I was imagining we were walking.
Yeah.
I also like that image.
All right, so it gets, a 19 on one and an explosion on the other one.
No.
All right, so 19... Let me write it down. 19, 12, reroll the 12, another 10.
Ugh.
So,
Well, I know what Dodger's doing.
Wait, why am I rolling a d12?
Yeah, I don't know any attributes that use that.
I grabbed the 12 instead of the 10. This might have saved you, Wendy.
It's so lonely, the d12 snuck in
it
there.
It did save you because I got a 1 on the d10.
Oh my god.
Lucky. We got to do something with that d12. let me see. That's a 20 even. What's your guard again, Wendy?
20.
Okay. So it goes to... I usually run it where I like to make it a little harder. It goes to the attacker.
Okay. So minimum.
It goes both ways if you got hit. Yeah.
Okay.
We'll say that this really rancid meat comes out of its gullet and just spills beside you. Thankfully, it does not get directly on you, because you can tell as it spews onto the ground, it eats through a little bit of the ground before it stops. So this is not very nice to get hit by.
Oh, no, not the bow.
Why can't you another one? Come on.
It's my only patch of hair.
Fair enough. Now we are to Dodger.
All right, well, if that happened, he was going to defend on that explosion, but since he's not, the thing hit the ground, right? So it's like right behind Wendy.
The vomit hit the ground.
Okay.
So it's still in the air.
How high in the air is it?
It hasn't been able to maintain much height. It is probably only about... Well, it drifted down. So it's probably about... Now it's about 10 feet off the ground because it's lost its flight.
Okay. Then he is going to turn about and attempt to attack it with his built-in flamethrower.
Yeah!
Our son designed this dog.
Oh.
And I was like,
he has no concept of the war crimes or anything like that. Right. No. Just what's cool.
Yep. And I thought it fit really well. Okay.
It barks. It comes out of its mouth.
So it's going to bark. That's all he has. Yeah, he doesn't. Yeah, he's just going to try. Oh, my word. That was natural 1, a 1, and a 2, so we're at a 4.
I forgot to read. Fizzles.
That over the internet, what I heard you say instead of bark was fart. I was like, oh, it comes out that end. Okay.
It was designed by a toddler.
Yep.
So. Hey, that's why it made even more sense to me.
Yeah. We're a little hot. I'll turn her. Okay. Woo. Okay. I meant our mic. Okay, so
sure he did.
Did you take away the d12s? So there it is. I'm reducing my resource die.
Did you need a d12? I took them all away.
Yeah, sorry, yeah. That's okay.
You do need one?
Oh, you got them right here.
I do.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that'll be Dodger.
All right. So Dodger.
I forgot to reload him.
And it's just like a little puff.
You had one job.
No, I had two apparently, and the batteries. Come on.
No, it was your job.
Dang it.
Sirs, danger. We need to run.
You're gonna keep running.
Oh my gosh.
All right. So now, let me see. There was three of them. Another one acts before Colton gets to, since he rolled so terribly.
Shocker.
let me see. It is going to come down. It has been able to maintain its height, so it is going to try and aim with a bit of disadvantage, unfortunately, on to the other one, the other fleshy one, since... You know, buzzards can't eat metal, as far as y'all know. All right. So, that's disadvantage. Not good. 13.
That's a miss.
Guard. Yeah.
Ooh, it's close.
Right. It's more close. Not a fighter.
Well, 13 misses, and it also, that its vomit splills, splashes down beside you, and you see the same as before. With that lovely, lovely smell wafting up. Of course, I mean, it's not like y'all have a problem with that smell, I guess, anyway.
I mean, fresh air is still better, but... yeah.
All right, so what do you want to do before the last one acts, Colt?
Oh, I actually get you. I assumed I was last. Okay. I am going to...
I was judicious how I spaced them out.
You're got a moment, sir. I was just
Y'all
there.
Weren't supposed to do anything before you got to Cisterna. I mean, it was going to start you off slow, but someone had to go shooting at the buzzards.
I'll spend out
shoot at things in the apocalypse and have nothing happen.
That is true.
I'm going to throw out that is her flaw of bravado. So
oh, yeah, that's true. Out there.
let me see. So I'm going to use my movement to try and catch up with the answer and attempt to get him back in to defense programming. I don't know. I guess we didn't talk, Moustache, if there's anything in particular.
I mean, I think you've been with him long enough. There's probably like some key words you can say.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing too.
Or maybe some.
Wait. Okay, try this. He's going to run up, get close, at shouting as he's running.
I have my tea. I have my tea. And. There's visitors at the door. Please deal with them. The tea is good. Maybe that should be it. The tea is good.
All right.
So I don't know if that's a major. Yeah, I would. I'll definitely do my creation. I guess just
flavored as engineering ish, right?
Yeah. His flavor on creation is engineering. So I'll just do that. And 2d8, added one advantage. No. Two advantage from the bolster.
Nice.
There it is.
There's another
All
one,
the
yes.
children's die. Okay, that's
Ooh,
better.
You got explodey.
Yes, one explodey, 15 on the d20. Nope, yeah, 15, so at a 30 total, plus 37 total.
Nice.
37. quite successful. So it can be flavored how I guess the answer will choose, but the answer is definitely able to get back into combat mode. And
all right.
As such, let me see. I'll reserve a positive point of some kind for y'all.
Sounds good.
Nice. Happens.
All right. So the last one has to act. It is also still quite far away and will come with it. Come closer, take a disadvantage, and try to probably puke on the one that is not trying to shoot them, because it's a softer target. Softer target, as far as it understands.
Not wrong.
Only an 8 on the d20. Only a 5. Not
super
awesome.
You got, like,
13 awesome.
Defense there? Colton?
15.
Yeah. 13.
Well, this was another 13. I got a...
Woo!
That's my lucky number,
lucky,
man.
Yeah.
It is tonight, so no puke. We will say this is the end of the initiative. We'll say at the end of the initiative, y'all have gotten quite a bit closer to the, you know, to Cisterna.
Yep,
because somebody's running at his regular speed.
Well, I guess I don't know if I'd be at my full speed since I'm hauling something.
That's fair.
True, but you didn't do anything else besides move. Also, so
right.
All right. That means we're back at the top of the initiative order. What does Wendy want to do?
Let me guess. Shoot something.
I'm gonna try again.
She's actually gonna try, because of her claw bravado, she's gonna try to do a two-shot.
Ooh.
The one that she hit, and then the next. Well, maybe the whatever one looks weakest next. So
that's definitely the one you shot at before.
Okay. So she's gonna hit two, so I get one disadvantage. Two disadvantage?
Two disadvantage, yeah.
Got it. So am I at normal?
Are you gonna try and run to keep up with us, or are you gonna fall
No,
behind?
She's gonna stop.
Okay. Then, so your focus action?
Yeah.
Yeah, then you're at a straight roll.
Straight roll. Okay.
Two advantage from attack special and focus action.
Okay. Yeah! Okay. 25.
That definitely hits. Definitely hits. In fact, it's 10 over. So.
Yeah! Dude, their legs come off.
Their legs come off.
She's leg biter.
My name is Wendy Leg Biter McCoy.
So not only does that, you got one, and its leg comes off. It's also dead, but its leg comes off. That was a really good success. So we're going to say, I'm going to bring that story point back then, since it was so good before a second ago. The story point will be that you guys, the success with a little more is that as you explode it, basically, with that shot, you see that it's not your shot necessarily that explodes it. It seems like where its stomach would be and its craw, it kind of explodes from there and showers down a bunch of acid as it dies. So you might want to think, probably best not be under one of these things when they die.
Oh, man. Okay. I imagine it's all in the slow motion, too, of the vats.
Yeah. Woman, would you catch up?
I'm coming.
That was pretty hot.
It seems like all of Dan's characters like a woman that can kick its butt.
Yeah.
All right.
This is actually the first time we're playing a married couple ever.
Yeah.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Thank
you. It's my honor to be your first married couple run. Yep. All right.
Sorry, we'll try not to be too mushy.
Well, I mean, you started off with combat, so it's not that mushy so far.
Yeah. I mean, what a way to start.
Depends on which kind of mushy you're talking about.
That's true. There's been a lot of mush, actually.
Wipe some of the throw up off.
So, we are to the answer then.
Yeah, so the answer is, oh, you like the tea? That is so wonderful. And it suddenly turns around real fast, which probably rips apart the harness or whatever was attaching it to the cart. And immediately aims the Gatling. Are there, because I've got two lines that I can shoot with to connect 20 feet. So are there two targets that I could hit, two of them?
Yeah, if he times it right, he could probably hit both of them by aiming just right.
Okay. So he's going to attempt to do that, use the Gatling to just shoot a line back and forth to try and just hit the two targets at once.
Okay.
With the Gatlings.
All right.
And so I'm not moving at this point. So I think I'll just take a focus to do that.
All right.
Let's see. D8s.
Answer the door.
Mm. Well, he is the answer.
Yep.
All right. So 14 and 12 is 26.
Nice.
26. Definitely. That hits both.
Nice.
All right. 26. Da-da-da-da. That one's down. This one. 6. All right. I assume that's guard?
Yes. Yeah, that would definitely be guard on that.
Yeah.
So they could, in theory, dodge those bullets. Spray and pray.
Yeah.
That doesn't beat him. Beat them their defense by 10 or anything?
It, actually, yes, it does. Yeah, it does.
Because
it's 15.
I'd like to provoke them so that if they do not attack me, they take disadvantage 3, I think. Yeah, disadvantage 3 if they do not target me in their attack.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Fair enough.
The threat of those Gatling guns is so much that they're focused more on me.
Gotcha. So, they take quite a bit of damage.
Proceeding to answer the door.
There you go. So, they have definitely been provoked. That is clear to see. They are swerving away from Wendy and going towards the answer. So, answer. Dead one is done. So now it's Dodger's turn.
Perfect. Okay. Try one. So he's gonna be like coughing. It looks like a dog that's like, or sneezing or something because the fluid's out. But there's gonna be this last little spark that's gonna like just do this explosion. So he's hoping to demoralize the one that's going to attack the answer.
Okay.
And he'll focus action because he's just sitting there like. All right, we got an exploding.
Nice.
Okay. Oh, another exploding. 22 total. Oh my goodness. 28. 31.
Asher's dice love you.
Asher does want a dog.
That is true.
All our, for those who don't know, all of Kristen's metal dice are colors of our children's birthstones.
Yes.
Oh, nice.
So we refer to them when we're rolling.
Fair enough.
Try not to judge our children based on the rolls.
And then mine are, yeah, you probably can't see. Mine are covered in blood.
Asher, you're dice.
Yeah, true. So anyways, so he's going to demoralize the closest one to the answer.
Okay, well, actually, with that exceptional success, I will let him demoralize both if he chooses.
Absolutely, because it's like he does it by accident. It's just right. Explosion. Guess there's a little left in the tank.
So the buzzards have swung around, and they both come at almost the same time, and that's the moment when poof, that flame cough kind of goes, poof, and they flutter back up before continuing on their path towards the answer, but have definitely felt that. And we'll see what they do. Let me see. First one is... But I don't know that they would keep going. Let me see. All right. The first one that flew over seemed to catch most of that explosion, and it goes and starts to fly off. It's like, none of this, no more. I'm out of here. And now it's Colton's turn before the other one acts.
Okay. What should he do?
What can you do?
Okay, whatever.
I'm kidding.
I'm playing a support character. No, I think what he'll do is do the main thing he does. He's going to, now that he's caught up to the answer, he's going to be quick, like, oh, I got to fix that again. He's going to start pulling out his tools and, like, adjusting and throwing some oil into the machinery and trying to bolster it. the answer.
Nice.
Okie dokie.
D8. So if he gets to shoot again, it will be good. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Okay.
There's an explodey.
Two explodies.
Oh, two?
Oh, yeah. I think nice. We got it. And 16, 21, 31 total. So that's a bolster PL6. So
nice.
Advantage 2 to the answer on attribute.
Woo!
Yeah, that feel good, buddy.
All right. So that means the last one. I'll roll to see if it is demoralized enough to leave, or if it's going to get if the answer and Wendy are going to get another pot shot at it. I guess Wendy could still shoot at the one that's
flying away. Let's see.
All right. This one is still coming on. It looks a bit strong, man. A little bit hungrier. So it is coming on, and it's definitely going to go after the robot and try and puke on the robot. So
I will point out that, you know, as long as the attack includes me, so if it tried to hit both targets with an area attack,
it's true. I am on top of the answer.
That is fair. Okay, so since they're both there, we will do that.
And it's demoralized?
Yep. Disadvantage 1 for my power level.
Okay.
Or for Dodger's power level.
These things are not rolling well tonight. Got a 19 on the main
Okay with that.
We got 19 on the main die, but a 2 on the other, so... 21.
Well, that D20 keeps getting 19s, it seems like.
One of them. Nothing doesn't matter if the other gets a 1 or a 2. But, so, 19 on that one. That was 21 for guard.
That definitely...
For a big, huge puke.
That all falls on Colton.
Well, some of it lands on me, but it just sloshes off the armor.
Gross. It's definitely acid, and it is eating at Colton's already sparse skin.
Yeah, that is 6 damage if they have Bane Focus.
They do.
Nice.
So, Bane Focus, it's Bane Focus, persistent damage.
Persistent damage, okay. Very good.
So there we go. All right. That was the last one. Back up to Wendy. One's flying away, Wendy. It's hightailing it out of there. And then the other is puking on Colton in the answer. So, there you go.
Okay. Well, she's gonna go after the one. She's gonna... What?
I'm fine with either way.
She's gonna go after the one and just not move still. Take a deep breath and try to shoot it down. All in one.
The one that's flying away, I'm assuming?
No, the one that's it's puked on them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. What would that be? That'd be 2 advantage?
Yep.
Okay. Go! Okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. That's good. 24.
Plus, that's exploding. Oh, no.
No, it's just 24.
I forgot.
All right, that is enough. Kills it too. So, yay, you killed it! While it's standing, sitting right over the top of Colton.
Oh no!
Yay! So,
what do you mean? Oh.
So,
not
let's
the smartest
see.
Cookie in the bunch. I guess.
Well, you can always try and use a defend interrupt to get under me fast enough.
Yeah. His agility.
Dodge.
Is hot.
Roll out of the way. I don't know.
Yeah, anyways. I will definitely try to avoid if I can, Adam. But your word is law.
You may try to avoid.
I will utilize. I have the climbing feet. So he's got his gear. He's always ready to, like. flip over, so he like quick straps his little thing to what used to attach the answer to the wagon. No longer, but he quick hooks in a carabiner there and tries to swing under the answer before it's too late.
Well, you think you do that because he's only got a 6 total. So, there you go. That final death throw explosion. 6. And this shower of viscera and now a corpse just going plop of the buzzard on the ground. And its own acid is kind of eating away at it as it's, you know, degrading and all that stuff. You see someone before you guys even recover, you see someone coming out, two or three people coming out from the cisterna. They're heading your way.
So I would totally try and take a shot at the one that's flying away.
Okay.
While you're bolstered.
Yeah. And while I'm bolstered, I'm uncoordinated, which is why I destroyed the harness. But now that you're underneath me, he's just going to like, because how far away is the buzzard thing right now, would you say?
It's trying to get away.
I got 150 feet without any disadvantage.
It is at the very minimum of that, at the very edge of that range. So it is at about 125, 160. Pretty close to the edge of your range, but you can still hit it.
And I'm bolstered now. Okay.
Boomity boom.
There we go. That'll be a 28.
28. That does hit.
And I kind of move towards it. So I don't know how low he's hanging, if he's going to get jostled around, hit the ground some, or hit some of my legs as I move uncoordinatedly towards this thing as I shoot at it.
Bump, smack, drag, 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 drag.
I could roll my agility or my might for moving and see that versus guard if you want.
If that's what you'd like to do, Dan.
Oh yeah, whatever you think for the flaw. Oh, do you want me to roll too, or it's just against my guard?
No, he tried to beat your guard, not to smack you around while you were under. Yeah, yeah.
No, that's fine. If that's what
agility is, a D8.
He's just hanging on. What is going on?
That's a 16.
Okay. I'm pretty sure that beats Colton's guard.
Yes. I won.
So. So no damage for Colton.
Yes, have been neutralized.
Yeah. Good job, buddy. I'm going to pull myself up and I'm going to try and shake the persistent damage with the brushing all the stuff off.
He like turns around and like heads back to the cart.
The cart seems to have sustained some damage.
Yeah. Thank you.
We should do those like quick release lock things.
Yep. Need the supplies.
Additional guests located.
Yeah, there's some people running up.
He's noticing the people rushing and is currently treating them as guests, quote unquote.
They need tea. Get they need tea. Warm up the water. What did we say? I always forget.
I don't know, you program it.
No,
Kinda.
He relaxes his stance a little bit, seeming to come out of pure attack mode at your words.
fair enough. So as you guys are messing around trying to get things situated on the cart stuff and keep the answer from answering the door, the others run up and you recognize you guys have probably been to the fort before, to Fort Smith area before, and Cisterna has been one of your stops before. The idea now is that what you're currently carrying is supposed to get to the bar over by the Damned 13. So if you have your maps up, if you are using them, you're trying to get from T to U over in the southern corner over there, southern right-hand corner if you're looking at it. So that's the southeast area. So T is where you are, and you've and someone runs up, someone you've recognized as being one of the various guards that's posted on the outside. Him and a couple of the others that you regularly see. His name's Steve. Just Steve. He says, "Oh, well, I thought that was y'all. I didn't realize y'all was coming today. It's been a while since you've been in here. What you doing, Colton? Hey, Wendy.
Hey, Steve. It was a good haul, and we thought we'd make our way straight here. Somebody just got a little excited at the end.
I didn't know they knew that.
I mean, we appreciate it. They've been kind of bugging the ranches around here, so it's not been something that we've been trying to. As long as we left them alone, they just ate the dead stuff, but appreciate it.
But they wanted something else dead here, so.
Alright. Alright, y'all come on in. Settle down a bit. Try not to... Try to keep the answer, your bot, a bit more controlled this time. Last time, the mayor wasn't very happy with what went on.
Yeah. Thanks for covering for us. I'm trying. We just gotta, we gotta keep the tea cold.
Keep. Why would you? Don't you want hot tea?
We do. When it's time, but it's not time right now, if you know what I mean.
The kettle's off.
Oh, no kettle. Yeah.
Gotta brew.
It's not tea time now. Right.
Yes.
Meanwhile, the answer has like gone over to one of the corpses and just like pokes it and then like throws it like 100 feet down the way as it uses its cannon guns to like kind of get under it and then just toss it away.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll be heading over to the bar. Yeah.
Yeah, we'd love to. We got some good stuff here, I think. We'd love to see what
You gonna drop any out here? You taking it all to the bar?
Well, if there's anything you're interested in, you could certainly take a look. We could also use some more batteries. I don't know if anyone's got any.
Oh, and those little small ones y'all keep looking for? We ain't got none of them small ones. We told you before we ain't got none of them small ones.
Maybe we can hook up to the charger or something.
I don't know. Maybe there's some over at Robco, but I doubt it. It's been pretty picked. Anyway, come on in. I'll tell him not to shoot y'all.
Much appreciated.
The answer kind of drives up in front of the cart.
Yeah, we'll see if we can cherry rig this real quick. The answer likes to have a purpose.
All right. Well, since there's no pressure, you can probably get it at least to Cisterna. It's not that far away after the answer drug it, his full movement closer. You guys can get in, and as far as you guys want to, you could unload some things here. There's a few the conceit of this particular game is that there's a few choice crates that you're carrying that go to the bar and nowhere else. But you do have some other things that can be traded out here if you'd like to.
Okay.
So here is your chance that you were going to be afforded to do to, you know, at the start.
To stack up.
To get yourself settled in.
So I think, like,
anything you need.
I think as we're, like, driving into town, you see, like, one of the watering holes or something. There's a the answer-sized hole that's been patched over where he went through the wall to enter because Colton said to come in. And so he just went in the fastest way.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
That's awesome.
You see some of the workers stop that are just finished patching it up and making it look like the rest, and they kind of watch.
Oh, by the way, did we get any legend points for using any of our flaws there?
Sure, y'all can have one more legend point each. Well, let me see, who did flaws?
I did.
Answer and Wendy did.
Yep.
Okie dokie. So one more.
I need some ammo, probably.
Stack up. Yeah, I like your idea of that quick release thing. We could see if there's something I could jerry-rig up. We'll need some oil, some batteries or chargers if we can find them, or if anyone's heard where some are.
The answer is like grabbing a metal pipe and causing it to toss out for Dodger to go retrieve and bring back to him.
That's so cute when the boys play.
Yeah.
Oh, we need some refill on torch fluid, too. Dodger's all out.
So we would know who to go to here for that, right? In the cistern.
You might check for...
Yeah.
You might check for special mortar ammo.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to quit. I've got up on the stream, too, the map real quick here.
Okay.
So everyone can see.
Cool, cool.
All right. And again, if you guys that are watching want this map, it is in the Discord as well as on the Twitter for the Inn Of Planar Crossroads. So...
Sweet.
You have to look back through our pictures, but it's there.
So we're down by T.
All right.
Very bottom, yeah, yeah.
You are. So you're currently shopping, stocking up there. To kind of keep it a bit tighter, since this is a one-shot, if you want to do any kind of socializing, mingling type of roles, you can, to get some information on where you're headed. And we'll say that you guys stock up what you're needing.
Okay. Yeah, for sure.
The answer can use their presence to, like, assist you in any roles. Like, just their very being there can help people, maybe.
Please don't Kool-Aid my cart, man. I just, it's been...
Okay.
He'll do it. That's it.
So, yeah, and then I'll
find out where batteries are.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's highest
Wendy
priority.
Wendy really wants that radio fixed.
Yeah.
She really wants to.
You know, it's like walking out there and it's just silence.
You can't just feel our love in the air.
Well, yeah, but, like, music helps, huh?
Yeah, all right.
I think that's our main concern.
Unfortunately, there are no such small batteries here. Robco Manufacturing over on Q, the Q, is a place that could possibly have some, but they aren't. That is a location. That is not a settlement.
Mm-hmm.
You know that there's old Robco Manufacturing.
And it's on the way.
It is on the way.
All right, we'll take a look.
Should we ask and see if anybody needs anything?
Yeah, I would, I'll use my, merchant perk, if I can, to see if, to optimize on our sales, and also get an idea what's everybody looking for as we're, once we head out, we know what's needed, so maybe that can direct where we go next.
Okay. Via your merchant perk, you're able to get several bottle caps ahead of what you were expecting to get for some of the stuff you brought in, some of the scrap especially.
Nice.
Apparently they were able to pick through and be like, oh, this one's got some filament in it, and oh, this one's got some gold in it that you needed, and so on and so forth. But you find out about the Robco manufacturing thing for the batteries. That's probably the most common place to find them. But it has been, as of right now, the Nuconauts and the Sarsaparilla 6 guns have been fighting over that area. And that's C and D is where they're headquartered. And they fight all the time. And Q is right there by it. And it's been particularly hot lately. So your friends and contacts here are recommending avoiding going to that area, maybe going to, risking going closer to the Mr. Pecan's Nutty Mix factory instead. And cutting just either south or north of it. That's where a lot of weird stuff happens, that a lot of the tweakers and stuff go there when they've gone too much. For some reason, they get attracted to the Mr. Pecan mascot on the side of the building and the statue. So that's what tends to happen. But as long as you don't do anything to get their attention, you usually don't have to deal with any of them. And then you could make it to Ben's settlement, which is a lot like Cisterna. It's a bit more, it's settled and a bit more peaceful, though it's not as big as Cisterna. So it's right over there at Inn. And from Inn, it's almost a straight shot to Bar. To the Bar. That seems to be your safest bet. If you want to play a bit more risky, you could risk going to the Robco and then cutting over to Inn. So Q to N to you.
How important are those batteries? Or do you risk destroying it when you try and jerry-rig it?
What do you say, woman?
What?
What do you want to do?
How hard is it to jerry-rig it?
Well, we can certainly find out. I'm always up for a challenge.
We can get another
one. Try and hook it up to the answer.
All right. Yeah, we'll give that a try. That way we can keep going. Do you want to stop by where the tweakers go? What's that called? Pecan? What is it?
Mr. Pecan's Nutty Mix Factory. Means safer.
All right.
You get this figured out. If you don't, we're going.
Yeah.
Up north.
Yeah. All right. Because this is so important to my beautiful wife. I'm going to utilize, if I can, my scavenger perk to find some supplies that will help me jerry-rig the radio to a new power supply.
All right.
And then I'll try to fix it.
All right. So.
Good luck. How else are we supposed to poke her?
This is true. All right, I'm going to do this. I'm thinking that I'm... Let me see here. Boons. I'm just checking what I have access to. Let's see. Genesis.
Can I help you in any
way? He says that in character, and he's actually doing it in person.
Yeah. Fumbling through my all the schematics and, like, throwing them back.
We got to find more of these things. I don't know why people just leave them around all the places.
Well, it's worth mentioning while he's looking that up, if you guys want to see kind of a visual representation of Mr. Pecan's Nutty Mix Factory, you can look about that place on the actual Fort Smith map in Google Maps and see that there is a Mr. Peanut Factory there. So that's where the idea was for it.
That's great.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even put that together. That's awesome, dude. Okay, yeah, so I'm kind of combining, if I can, my scavenger perk with the ability to do, like, the Genesis boon to create. I can create permanent matter, you know, based on the mechanics of it. But the idea is that he's finding the parts he needs and kind of jerry-rigging this power source.
Okay.
Can I help you anyway? I'll hold things. I'll hold your tools.
Yeah, yeah, all right. Yeah, you just stand there and look pretty. Look, that bow, it made it.
It did.
So I'll get one more from 8 ally. Oh, natural 20! You know, on the important rolls.
Oh, we're going to hang out with the tweakers today.
All right, so we're at a 34 with an exploding d20. For another 8, that's a 32. 42.
32.
Wait, didn't you say 32?
Yeah, you're right, 42.
42.
See, 42. You aided me.
Okay. I try to help. I'm homeschooling.
So she says, no, 42. And you're like, oh yeah, 42, the answer to everything. That's what you said it to. That's what it has to be.
Yes, you need something.
I will in just a second, buddy.
For the power source for the radio, you are able to rig it. You had to down pedal some of the power from a actual, let me see, power cell, an actual cell from an atomic one. And you took one from a laser musket that's almost gone anyway. And it was just about right. You had to do a few little rigmarigs with it, but it's done. You're kind of proud of yourself. You kind of proud of yourself. It's like that. I don't you some, you know.
Well, yeah, polka tonight.
One of the other. So.
I really mean poking. Like we like to polka.
So, you guys have that made, and you're pretty sure it'll work. You've made an external. It has to sit outside of this radio, but you've made one.
Cool.
Beautiful. All right, now we can now we can go.
Now we go. We're gonna go to the pecan place. Pecan? Yeah, pecan.
Okay.
Are we actually going there, or are we avoiding it? Going to the north or south, like the people said, and then going on to you?
The safe way.
It's a little bit north of there, but not quite. To Q, right?
If you go in between Q and R, you are less likely to encounter anything nasty.
That.
If you're that space that is black right there that says Fort Chaffee and it has J on it, that is a very, the closer you get to that, the more big bad things there are.
With
so
claws.
That's why they said probably, usually with claws, usually with teeth.
Horns and teeth and
that.
Claws and big nasty things.
Bombard them from 180 feet.
Yeah.
or 1,800 feet. 1,800 feet.
Mm.
So we will take the safest route that we were told.
Yeah, that sounds good. How do you feel about it? The answer.
That seems logical.
Alright. Come on, Dodger.
So, I like to do exploration type roles. So what attributes would you guys like to do on your trek from T around R? And are you going to stop in at Ben's settlement before you go to the bar? Or are you going to go straight to the bar? It's up to you.
Go to Ben's.
Yeah, yeah, I like that idea. Mm-hmm. If we have any leftover stuff or if we pick up stuff
on the
way.
Pick up anything new, yeah.
Is this where, like, each of us are doing a role or just one of us is doing a role?
Each person will do a role that is thematically aiding the party to get where they're going. Mm-hmm. So.
Well, I'm going to be using my mini binoculars, looking out, checking out along the way, making sure we're safe and if there's any good stuff out there. Broken down things, people who just died, left stuff, you know.
Okie dokie. Always loot the corpse. There you go. All right.
See how many bottle caps they have.
And Dodger, could Dodger assist her? He has the scent perk.
He can assist one, either you or her, or the answer, you know, one of y'all.
Okay.
He'll stay with Wendy.
Do we have, like, a target CR for this, or?
Yeah.
What's the...
Yes, Kristen in my wants... head you do.
She's waiting. Like, it'll make it... You got advantage from... All right.
So is this just one? Yeah. 25.
Nice, girl.
Oh, yeah, that's plenty. You chose the safest route, so it's not the hardest thing. So y'all know it's less than 20. I can teach y'all, I can do like I do with my class. You know that it's less than 20 and more than 10.
That is true.
I think Colton will use his logic as we're traveling along to both keep us en route and make sure we're trying to, from whatever Wendy spots, I'm picking out the best stuff that can sell.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's it. Come on now. Not great. 11.
11. Uh-oh. All right.
So, I have access to precognition, power level 1. Which is like a simple like yes, no, if that's a good idea. And the way that's flavored is like the computing power going, you know, seeing different possibilities, right? So could I like maybe roll that to maybe assist him and give him a re-roll on that? If I get the power level, I only got 1 point in it, so I've got to...
If you roll well enough, yeah, if you get the power level for it, yeah.
I'm rolling a d4. I need to get... a 12 for power level 1.
It's doable.
Doable. Well, I got a 15 on the d20.
Ah,
okay.
There we go.
Fate is on our side.
And I exploded on the 4.
Oh, how high do you get then?
And again.
Oh. Nice.
So that's 4, 4, and 3. 11 plus 15, so that's 26.
Nice. 26. See, it's that advanced computing unit. It's all that tweaking that that Colton's been doing.
It's not.
Yeah, as you're going, it's
actually Colton. That is poor logic. You messed up with these numbers and must go that way instead.
That's totally what I said.
Colton's accidentally building an actually robot. All right. Works for me, and that is successful enough for that reroll to take place that was asked for.
Get better than 11 there.
Yeah.
Didn't you roll last year's dice?
Don't miss it by 10. Don't miss it by 10.
No, I mean, you don't have to.
She wants me to roll Asher's dice.
Seems to like you. See?
Yeah.
He likes hey. You.
23.
Okay. Nothing fun happens. All right. I can't truly say that. So, as you're going around, you go around to the north, and you skirt closer to Mr. Pecans than you do the Robco. You definitely hear a few laser blasts going off between over by the Robco. Apparently, both the Sarsaparilla 6 guns and the Nuka Knots are fighting today over there. As you get closer to Mr. Pecans, you see that they are not quiet either. Apparently, they decided to be shooting off fireworks, and there's not a context for it in the Fallout universe, but they're having a rave, and they decided to have a rave tonight.
That's awesome.
And there's an occasional laser blast over there, too. So they're distracted with what they're doing. So you guys are able to safely make it through, and you do find a few unfortunate victims of the wastes, as well as, let me see, based on that roll, as well as a robot that was basically built out of a bunch of different parts and junk that you think might sell pretty well. Nice. At least, even if in pieces.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Good find.
I think at one point, as we're passing somewhat near the rave, like as some fireworks go off and laser fire, I think for a second the answer will like bunker down and the mortars come out as he's turning, as if he's getting ready to fire.
He's cold.
Should I eliminate this noise?
No, they're brewing their own tea over there, you know? It's fine.
And they are. So. All right. So y'all are safely able to make it to Ben's settlement. Ben's settlement is much smaller. It was started by one guy who named himself after the place he found, which is Ben.
Wait, so, he named himself after the place, or he named the place after himself?
No. He saw a sign that was there, and he decided it was Ben's. There was just a Ben and then an S in the broken sign. It's like, it's mine now. Ben's. So he renamed himself Ben, and now it's his. And it's a bit odd. You know, people here are a bit odd. But it's the waste, so they're not that odd. Because it's so close to the bar, there's a few more ghouls than there are humans. But, you know, it's about a 50-50 ratio. You do see one super mutant in town. But he doesn't. It doesn't seem to be bothering anybody. It actually works on the south gate. You guys are coming in on the east, kind of northeast gate. Northwest gate, excuse me. Northwest.
He's new. You never know what you're going to see at Ben's, I guess.
Yeah. Ben's is actually made of... there's a bunch of houses that have incorporated old play school equipment... old play, playground equipment into their... into their town as a thing. So...
spin around on one of those safe spinny round things. Whee!
The answer starts to wheel towards one as if he's going to get on.
It's a little too big for you, buddy. You could probably spin in a circle. I don't know, we could work on giving you a 0.2.
Oh, no. You just... all right, let's see. Let me roll my agility and see what happens here.
Oh no. I said we could give it to whatever.
Well, that's a five. So what happens when he starts to spin in a circle here?
So she starts spinning on that, and the answer kind of starts to spin at the same speed until it gets a little bit much, and he gets on a wheelie basically, and what kicks on is the radio kicks on, and a Pennsylvania polka dun, 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 starts to play over the radio, and polka music starts going on. Let me see how everybody likes this.
Everybody likes a polka.
You. A tipsy robot. I rolled an 18.
Do 1, 2, 3.
I rolled an 18, so everybody thinks that you guys came into town and are inviting them for polka.
Okay.
So it turns out okay. Unfortunately, you might want to repair a little bit on the answer, because he twists tracks off of his wheels, off of his, you know, track. So he doesn't get the full polka experience, unfortunately. So you might want to fix that before heading out.
Alright.
No, it's 1, 2.
But everybody else is having a fun time with the polka.
Cool. I'm sorry, honey. I'll dance with you later. I gotta deal with.
Nah, I'll teach everybody else. I'm gonna teach everybody the polka.
Roll me something appropriate for teaching everybody to polka while he rolls something for fixing on the answer.
Yes.
And we'll see what happens.
I don't know. I'm we'll in between agility or presence, but I don't know.
I would say presence, since you're teaching a bunch of people.
Okay, okay. I need one of those. Took them all.
Say.
Ah, well, 15. It's not bad.
It's not bad.
Oh, nice.
All right, all right. 10, 28.
28.
I'm kind of vibing on restoration through creation to fix his wheels.
Yeah. All right, so she's off teaching trying to teach everybody, and the super mutant came off his shift. So he's over there, and she's teaching the super mutant to polka, and everybody's kind of following along with the super mutant. And everybody's got it. And you do well enough that you not only get you get that back on real easy. Apparently it wasn't that bad. And also, you're like, you know, he might need a subroutine for polka. And you kind of throw something together real quick.
Yeah, and that's good.
And so by the end of the night, everybody is polkaing, including the answer and the super mutant, who are about the same size of each other to do the polka.
Perfect.
That's perfect.
So.
got a nice dance partner.
There you go. Some fun is had in the wasteland.
That's what we do.
I'll say some Nuka-Cola.
Oh, I'm empty, but cheers. Cheers.
Yep. All right. Okay, so you made it to Ben's and had a good time polking. And now all you've got to do is get to the bar.
That's it. Easy.
That's it.
Easy.
Let's get some information.
As you can see...
I'm so tired.
The bar is pretty close to Jay, which is the chaff, where all the bad things go. Where the chaff of where the chaff of Fort Smith goes when it's too bad.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Can we get any intel from Ben's on how the trek there has been? have they seen anybody come from or to there?
All right. You guys are... Go ahead and roll me your researches for that. Mm. And how you would like to look for that. Because there is something to find here if you roll well enough.
Oh, okay.
Do you want us each to do a roll, or...?
You may each do a roll. If you want to assist someone else or something like that, that is also an option.
I think I'll chat up the super mutant. You know, maybe they've been around that area or something previously, or heard something. Since I'm, you know, dance partner and stuff, so I guess I would use my presence to kind of chat with them.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. Excuse me. Okay.
I'll do presence as well, and if I can utilize the merchant perk again, just for that access to the right people, the people who would be making that travel, I know who to talk to who's been traveling recently, and hopefully people I can trust.
Mm-hmm.
I got a 20,
23. Nice.
23. Nice. Well, I mean, he likes it. It likes its part, its dance partner. So, you know, it wasn't too hard to convince some information, glean some information from the super mutants. So we'll piece that together in a second with everybody.
I'm still deciding. You roll.
Yeah. All right. Oh. Not good. No. Nine.
Nine.
Man. I feel like I want to use my well-rounded because I got a bunch of things, but I'm just like persuasion to talk to people, try to persuade people to tell us what's going on and stuff, because also I have cosmetic deformity, so I'm kind of like, it's a battle between the two, I guess, in a way, because I want to be able to talk to people. They don't really want to talk to me because I'm a ghoul kind of thing. But
it depends who you're talking up to.
Yeah,
there are more ghouls here.
Yeah, so. Okay. Maybe then I'm talking to the ghoul peoples, persuading them to tell us.
And maybe Dodger's being super cute around you and helping.
Yeah.
So you get a thing from well-rounded, and then he'll assist you.
He'll assist me? Okay.
With his presence, basically.
Okay. Oh, well, I got a one, but I got a explodey, so we'll see what happens.
Explode
okay,
again.
You can't complain about one and then say, oh, I got an explodey.
It didn't help.
So it was only a 10.
But it's a 10.
Yep.
I'm just really awkward with people.
Well, so coming down the line then, so with Wendy, everybody's really more interested in the polka stuff, because they hadn't seen the particular variation that you're showing them, and they're like, no, what? Yeah, the bar's over there. It's over there, and we enjoy it. You just go down and you follow the road. It's no big deal. So what about this right here? What's the next step? And so they're a bit more involved in that. You do get that the road is still there. It's still... You still take that same 255, I think it is. Whatever it is on the map. The 250-something. Mm-hmm. And that's the same one that everybody takes to get to the bar.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just their suggestion, because they're more interested. Colton, you do know from the merchant side of things, all you can really glean from it is that the damned 13... And they mean the actual damned 13, which are the 13 leaders of... The 13 kind of mysterious leaders of the damned 13.
Mm-hmm.
They are waiting on something that they've been... they have ordered. Everybody knows that they've ordered something to come in.
Okay.
So, it's something everybody seems to know at the moment.
Okay.
But thankfully, our sentry bot buddy is able to chat up the super mutant who has faint memories of their past being a young lady who loved to dance before she became a super mutant. Super mutants here are a bit, they have a weird kind of hue to their skin. It's not nightkin purple, but it's also not quite green, not quite a deep green. There's this weird kind of olive flesh that sets in with them that sometimes has those other hues. And it says, it calls itself Dancer, actually. So we'll say that.
Uh-huh.
The Dancer awesome. Says,
yeah, I was Dancer before. I heard,
she said, it says as they're dancing around,
that everybody knows something big's coming for the damned 13. Everybody knows they got a shipment of something coming in. Some people were taking it to them, didn't know what it was, just ordered it. That's what I heard. And I heard,
looks around,
that other people's knows. I heard they watching the road. Don't know if you's the ones, but don't take the road with the caravan.
So yeah, the answer will kind of nod along and say,
well, that is good information. Thank you. Let's do that fifth move back again.
Oh, don't step on toes.
So, all right. So now you guys got some of the information, thankfully with a well enough roll to know that might want to avoid that if you want to avoid some nastiness.
So I think that later that night, I guess, when I don't know what time of day it is or whatever, if we're leaving in the next morning, but later when we're, you know, just the four of us, the answer would be like,
Colton, I heard that there is a shipment on the road that we should look out for.
Did you hear it was coming soon, or?
Yes, it's being delivered to...
I forgot who you said it's being delivered to. The
damn 13.
The information gained in plain English is that the damned 13, the actual leaders at the dam, they ordered something through somebody. No one's clear on who, and no one's clear on who's bringing it to them. But the road to the bar is being watched. This 250-something road is being watched. That's the information in plain English.
Yeah, so basically the answer, like, tells you that, yeah, we should totally be on the lookout because there's some people delivering something to the damn 13 that is apparently really important, but the people delivering it don't have any clue what it is. So we should look for that shipment.
Hmm. All right. Thanks. That's good. That's good to know. I hope it's not us.
Why do they always do these things? What are we carrying?
I don't think anything. I don't know. I mean, we did good back at the Cisterna.
Do we know anything about what we're carrying?
Well, you know there's at least two crates that you haven't popped open.
And is it one of those things where we were given that crate to go deliver to these people and that we shouldn't pop it open?
Well, you were told to deliver it to the bar. It's got a seal. It's got, like, you know, a paper seal around it, so it doesn't. It knows if it's been broken or not.
Oh no!
You know, the answer does have some detection abilities.
I like that a lot. What? What? Why don't you check and see who's hanging out inside the box there? The answer, if you can.
So yeah, with my one point in prescience, I've got the detection boon. I can attempt to pull up to scan.
Colton,
be like
Wendy.
A combination of X-ray and radio signals or something.
Yeah. And the McCoys are just gonna be totally behind the answer, just like peeking around.
All right.
You're made of lead, right?
Parts of him.
Okay.
So you want me to just straight roll for that, or?
Yeah.
Could I attempt to bolster before he does? By
theoretically.
Theoretically, fair enough. I'll give it.
Let me see if I can just get in here and see what we got going on.
Tweak some of the sensor settings or something like that.
Mm-hmm. All right. We got, yes, 12, 18, 30 total. So that is successful.
How much bolster is that? Is that
two.
One or two?
Power level 6.
Nice.
Well, that just helped the D4 explode.
Yay!
Good.
Oh, and it just exploded again.
Yeah.
All right.
8, 8, 2. So that's 10 from the D4 plus the 12. So that's a 22 total.
Yeah. Okay.
22 total. All right.
Sorry, I forgot my head was turned away from the mic.
Oh, you're good.
Okay. Oh. Like waiting. What?
Perfectly timed.
Yeah, 22 total, so definitely enough to get detection.
All right. You can tell there seems to be some packaging around it, like straw, you know, some kind of buffer packaging around it. Based upon what your sensors are getting back, there's some electronic stuff in there and things like that, but there's also something dense in the packed in the middle of all that other stuff. And it seems to be a dense thing. You're guessing that it is most likely a lead casing for something. And the crate is big enough. The two crates themselves, one's larger, one's smaller. The larger one is where that is. The smaller one also has a seal around it and stuff like that. And it's only about a 5x5. It's only about a 3x2 kind of rectangle, but the 5x5 one that you've been hauling around that's supposed to go to the bar, it's the one with that has that lump of thin lead casing inside of it somewhere, most likely in the middle. And you know that that's not usually how it is. Usually people don't ship those type of things that way. It's the wasteland. You just throw the lead in the lead case in the back by itself.
Mm.
So.
Nothing to worry yourself over. Just draw some electronics and a dense lead box of some sort.
I don't like the sound of that.
Can I use any learning to think of what that might mean?
You can certainly try.
Like, how big is the lead box, too?
Based upon the scan, the lead box would be, if that's a 5x5, it is about a 3 foot long and 1 foot tall rectangular box. But it has... The scan's well enough to know that it has rounded edges on it, so it's almost like it's all one piece.
Okay. Yeah, so I'd relate that information.
So 15.
Mm, 15, you'd probably think, oh, that's probably got some kind of, maybe it's a weapon type of attachment, or maybe it's something else, maybe some kind of, it's got to have something to do with the other machinery that's in there. But without breaking it open, how will you know what type of machinery is in there?
Yeah. Well, I think it's machinery. Guns, maybe, something.
Do we know how many bottle caps we're getting for delivering this thing?
For this one? Let me see. It's hard to play around with currency. Let's say that...
would it be a big amount, small amount?
If you were to deliver it successfully, unharmed, this shipment would probably bump your wealth level up by 2 instead of 1.
Ooh.
Briefly. For like a single purchase type of thing.
Mm.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. So it's pretty good.
And what would... This is just meta for world. Would there be a specific feeling we would have towards the damn 13, or is that up to us to decide?
It's a little bit up to y'all. If okay. you decide that you're from here, I don't remember right. if you guys decided if you were from here or not.
Yeah, we thought the bar made sense. At least for the McCoys, generally speaking.
Okay. So, being from the bar, you would know that the damned 13 are... They're believed to be ghouls. There are 13 ghouls that run the dam, and they live there because they become glowing ones by being exposed to the dam for so long.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes a damned 13 will die, and sometime and they'll just another person from the bar will be chosen, and they'll go and be a part of the damned 13. So there's always 13. As far as the bar is concerned, they're their biggest ally within all of this map.
Okay.
Because they are themselves ghouls. That doesn't mean that they're the best buddies or mm-hmm. that they're the nicest people to be around, but they are the biggest aid to the bar and have more than once been quite effective in staving off the chaff as well as things that come out of the river.
Okay.
I kind of think we just get it to him.
Yeah. Should we try to be careful?
Might need to go.
Go around. Maybe head a little bit north.
Head a little right. south.
No, I don't like what's so right down now in you're the at south.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, with you know, sentry bots can off-road it pretty easy, at least based on the games.
Mm-hmm.
They're chasing you down.
What if we just head like slightly north of the road of 255?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah.
There's
a road that goes north from 255, Mazard.
Yeah.
So you could choose to go to Mazard, or you can cut across M, which is the airport, and try to get up to Mazard. Try to get up to Rogers instead, which is 22. And that's another. At least the way we're playing it right now, these main roads are pretty much safe to travel. They're the ways that you kind of get around. Everybody kind of knows.
Okay.
No one tolls the roads because everybody wants to use them. Mm-hmm. So no one tries to control them because then everybody would be on them about trying to control them. So it's kind of a mutually assured destruction thing.
Mm. Right. Go head north and then hit 22 and head down.
I mean, if everyone's watching this road and it seems like everybody knows they're expecting a package... Yeah. Maybe that's the best bet.
Okay.
Go up there. Just act like everything is normal. Everything's fine.
But it is. It's fine.
Uh-huh. I don't like anything covered in lead casing and then hidden.
Yeah.
All right. If you're good with that, the answer.
The answer just, like, looks around. It's just, like, being a sentry bot right now, making sure there's no danger coming towards you guys.
I think he's good with it.
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
What's that road? I don't remember. The little one. Heads north and then hits 22. We'll do that.
Yep.
Mazard.
That one.
Mazard it is.
There be any benefit going into the airport? Like, is there stuff to maybe scavenge on the way?
The airport's kind of been picked. There's been a little bit of activity around there that you guys probably would have heard of that. There's been a little bit of activity around there with some people calling themselves a brotherhood of some kind coming up from the south and landing there occasionally, kind of making it. No one uses it specifically because it's flat, open, and can't grow anything. Or can't do anything. So no one's used it yet or seized it. And there seems to be some seizing going on by a pretty strong force.
Yeah, I say we probably avoid the airport.
Wait, I thought we...
No. I mean, we don't have to go through the airport. We'll go up Mazard.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
It's funny hearing y'all talk like that because it's like, that's the actual name of the road and this is actually 252.
Okay. Oh, yeah. All right, I see what you're saying. That's Mazard.
Yeah. We're not going to go through the airport. We'll avoid that.
Okay.
Whatever's happening there. Head up the road, go down 22.
We'll have to be careful while we're on the main highway there for a bit.
I guess, yeah.
But, all right. Yeah, let's psych them out. Who are we psyching out?
Okay.
I don't know, but yeah.
All right. So y'all head out from Ben's, and it's not very far at all to Mazard. So you go down, and make perception checks as you are leaving and heading out and going to 52 to get to Mazard.
Dodger will assist you.
Me?
Yeah.
Okay. Woo. If I can do math.
Maybe I should teach a class when I'm up there.
Yeah.
31.
Nice.
31.
All right.
Got a 21.
31, 21.
We're doing simple math.
Right.
We're doing kindergarten math right now. 1 plus 1.
18.
1 plus 3.
31, 21, and 18. Now roll me a d20. Now each of you roll me a d20 and let me see. A d8.
I just exploded on the d20.
Oh no.
Unless it's a bad thing. I don't know. Do we add them together?
You're not adding all of y'all together, no.
Just my roll? A 17.
40 altogether.
40?
Oh, well, I balanced you out. I got a natural 1.
Oh.
7 total for mine.
The whole range. The whole spectrum.
Yeah, that's what we do.
Well, thankfully, you guys rolled for the bad guys hiding, and someone's tailing you. Thankfully, you beat their rolls enough. You beat their challenge roll. So, you know you're being followed right about until you get to Mazard. And when you turn off, there's this hesitation there. And that's when you see them. That's when you know for sure you've been followed. Is that they look and they kind of talk at each other. It's someone that's about human-sized, someone that's slightly larger than human size, but doesn't look like a full-on giant, full-on super mutant or anything, but looks big for a human. And then there is a bot with them. And you know they're following, but they seem kind of hesitant now that you've gone up Mazard instead of going to 55.
I could mortar them.
You are far enough away to mortar. And you say that with a little draw in your voice. You're far enough away to moiter them. And it's about the same thing.
Same difference.
What do you think?
No, I don't.
We just keep going.
I say we keep going.
Act normal.
What kind of bot is it?
What kind of bot?
Yeah.
It looks like a modified sentry bot. Well, no, it wouldn't look like a mod. It's an Assaultron. It's an Assaultron.
So how about we just play a radio? Make us sound all like casually Assaultron walking.
Useful parts for upgrading.
We don't know where they are. They could be friends. They came from bands, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, you didn't necessarily see when they started following you. But you did see that they followed you.
If the mortars do not take them out, we still have plenty of space to shoot.
If they have mortars,
down it. I'm just concerned about if the damned have somebody following us. Because we're not even supposed to know. We're the ones that know. I lean towards we keep an eye out, and if they
search the memory banks of the bot afterwards.
The answer really, really wants an Assaultron head upgrade.
Let's just see if they follow. They follow. Yeah.
Yeah, I think. Let's give them one. Let's give them one more chance.
And if so for the answer, if they even take one step towards the party, once they're moving, he's immediately going to turn around and fire a mortar shell at them.
That's perfect.
Okay. Well, they indeed do that.
Okay.
So. You guys, the answer at least gets a free shot off before everything breaks loose.
Okay.
So go ahead and roll me that mortar shot.
All right.
And see, you roll high enough, you may just take them all out at once.
Well, this is a 20-foot cube. It's a 20-foot cube. Let me double check that.
I think that'll get everybody.
That'll do.
Yeah. Okay.
That'll do, bot.
So yeah, it's a 20-foot cube here. Advantage 3. Do I get another advantage because they're probably surprised?
They're surprised, all right, that you just one step and it's... Because they don't know you have that mortar on you. Because you don't use it in town, so...
Right.
Thankfully.
Yeah.
You hope you don't use it in town. Colton and Wendy don't want you using it in town.
Yeah. So far, they haven't used it.
So far, only the Kool-Aid Man incident has been the roughest thing to deal with.
Yes.
All right, so after that first set of rolls, I'm at 29, but I exploded on a D8.
Okay.
Oh, my.
That's a 33 in a 20-foot cube.
33 in a 20-foot cube.
So you guys, we start moving forward, and suddenly the wheels widen out, the mortar comes fully out, and the torso turns fully around, and big old black concussive blast that currently, because he needs further upgrades for the mortar weapon, it causes him to be stunned.
Nice.
As he shoots.
They are following. Targets acquired.
Oh. Oh, I wasn't specific enough.
All right. Well, you see this, like, it's not a mini nuke, but it's kind of a mini nuke cloud no. that goes, and you see, as the smoke kind of settles, the only thing coming toward you now is the Assaultron. The other two are booking it. They are like, and you see that one of them looks like a regular humanoid, a ghoul probably. The other looks like a mutant of some kind. Not necessarily human, but you're not sure. It's one of those weird type of situations. Mm. But they're not sticking around for you to get a view either. They are leaving. And the only thing following you now is the Assaultron. And it's coming at you. And now we can roll initiative. So
Okay. I love it.
Ooh. Let's see. D8.
Am I doing this right? So it's 2d10. Dice pool higher.
20.
Not for initiative. Right.
23. So
yeah.
So though I am currently stunned, yes. So I only get one action.
No, you're good.
Okay.
20.
All right.
Dirty 20.
What? Colton has no agility, so it's just a D20. Dodger is 14.
20. All right.
And Colton is 8.
8. Not very fast.
Side note, are we doing any breaks or anything?
You guys are going to be finishing up soon, so... If anybody needs a bathroom break, this is the final combat, is what I'm saying. Unless you guys pull a Wendy, this is your final combat. So,
yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you need a break, Moustache?
I'll need you to go to the bathroom soon.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, your turn is up first, so if you want to go ahead and take your turn,
yeah,
and run and then come back.
So, how far away is everything?
It hasn't gotten that much closer. It's definitely, I would say, how far does the mortar go again?
Its default range is 300 feet, or, well, for me, it's 600 feet because of long shot, but.
Right. They were probably 600 feet away. You guys got them way before they were going to pounce or anything like that. Nah. So.
That's awesome.
All right. Yep. And have they separated enough? Like, how far away are the two from the Assaultron?
Oh, they're taking their full movement to get away. They're taking all their actions to get away. They're like, this was not what we signed up for type of thing.
I think he's going to try and take a shot on the two.
Oh.
With mortar no. again.
No mercy.
Because he figures Wendy's a good shot. And he's got time. plus he's a little stunned, so he sees them running away, and he, you know, they might get reinforcements, so yeah, he's gonna take another shot. Fair. So if they're farther than 600, then he'll be at disadvantage one.
They are, if the Assaultron's at 600, they are farther than 600, so yeah.
So I just got advantage 2. I got a 19 on the D20, so it's a 29 altogether on the two fleeing guys.
Oh yeah, they. So the first hit them, and they just like, oh no, we're leaving. And they start booking it. The second... And you, it's almost like it wobbles in the air for a second as Colton and Wendy watch it. But the shell stays true and goes... Again. And... they don't really get up this time. They don't look dead. Because they're kind of... But they are... They're laying on the ground. There's blood. It's like... Think somebody kneecapped him. Somebody ankle bit him. So.
And you would, Colton, you would be aware that two shots in a row is rough. So basically, I'm stunned for the next two rounds after this. I did two shots in a row. And I'm going to go use the bathroom, so I'll be right back.
Sounds good.
Uh-oh. He's going to be a little... That was a little much.
Maybe we can get some stuff off of the guy.
Think next person's up. Next person up is Wendy.
Yeah. So I don't think I can shoot that far, but I'll try.
The assault tron is at 600.
Yeah. I have.
You're 125, so it might be out of range completely, actually.
Is it out of range completely? Or do I just take a disadvantage?
I think you can go up to three times your distance, which would put you closer.
I let people take up to five disadvantage.
Okay.
But that's me.
Okay.
No, you're the boss.
I'm going to, like, lean down on my knee, focus actioning kind of thing. So I don't know how many disadvantage that would be for a regular rifle.
If it's five or less, you can try.
Let's see. 125, I think, was the distance. So 250, 375, 525. It's right about the five. It's between the five and four.
Why not?
All right.
Take a pot shot.
Yeah, when do you really get to roll with five disadvantage?
What's the worst that could happen? Why not? Yeah. So, okay. So
going to battle trends. Going to battle trends.
Yeah, she's focusing. She's getting into her zone. Yeah.
So you're at three advantage. That brings you down to two disadvantage.
So two disadvantage. Okay. Two disadvantage. Okay.
Yep. Spend a legend point.
Yeah, I'll spend a legend point. Why not? She just do it.
It's not like she's got a lucky in her back pocket if she needs it.
I know, right? If I got one disadvantage.
Yep. Plus one to the roll.
Plus one to the roll. Cool. It's not bad.
Oh,
I lost the explodey, but that's okay. That's okay.
Yeah, that's still good.
24.
24. Well.
not bad for five disadvantages.
That is true. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you seem to roll better with me than you do with Dan.
I know. What is up with this?
So... all right. That does hit.
Cool.
It does hit. You have successfully hit, after five disadvantage, the assault tron. Not for much, but you did.
That's all that matters.
Feel good about it. Yeah, baby, nice. Got it. Tink,
that sound, you know?
It's so far away. You
get the little X's like in first person shooter. Tink.
Yeah. It's far enough away you get that pause before the...
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool.
Oh, that's
all
so
right.
Good.
Well, that was successful. Unfortunately, now it moves closer. Let me see. It's going to move. And it is going to... You see that its eye is glowing. It's charging its beam as it's moving closer. So it takes two movements closer... And it's charging its beam.
Oh, dear. That's not good.
So let me see.
Spread out!
All right.
Managed to pot shot it from a distance there?
Yeah!
I told him I let people take up to... I do this with the kids, too, and they've done it once in the class. They've taken up to five disadvantage. After five disadvantage, I'm like, you're not gonna... We're not doing that.
I did it.
Awesome.
Oddly enough, they succeeded at 5 disadvantage too. So, I'm not sure how successful that 5 disadvantage thing is, but I'm rolling with it.
I mean, she did spend a legend point.
I did.
Put everything into it.
Yeah.
Nice.
All right.
I forgot the plus one. What was the plus one then?
We're,
to it?
We add are another Dodger damage and Colton. To that thing.
Dodger
thing. One more damage, huh?
Just one more legend point. I forgot.
All right. So.
Unless it was minimum damage, then it doesn't matter. But. Right? I don't know.
Well, plus one to. Let the boss
sure.
decide. Sure. Dodger.
I got numbers written down.
Okay, Dodger is gonna focus action as well, and he's gonna pump out a barrier in front of Wendy. That's obscuring, hopefully.
Ooh.
So it's like smoke.
Okay.
That's
smoke will
fun.
Come out. And he's going to focus action on it. Hopefully. No explodies, but I think. Yeah. 20, which gets me up to power level 5. Just quick check on there. I think I only can do one. Oh, no. That's the upper one. So it'll be obscuring and hindering. So
okay.
So hopefully giving her cover where she can kind of pop around and take a shot and then pop back behind it. And then
all right.
Colton will do what hopefully he does. I assume Colton as well. Me and the pup at the end. We'll do what we do best, theoretically, and attempt a bolster. I'm going to see if I can do a tweak to Darlene as well as you know what, actually what would be better,
can you reduce a stun?
I'm gonna reduce a stun,
yeah,
if I can. Moustache, I don't know, I assume that's from an item,
but it's kind of a flavor thing to put on an item in order to have more deadly on it. The back until it gets upgraded to wealth level 4, it stuns me, and at wealth level 4 it immobilizes me, so that's up to Adam if you can remove that.
I would spend my turn on restoration.
I think I'd allow it since it's... I think I'd allow it you to remove one of the stuns. Not both of them, but one
gotcha.
Of them.
Yep. Okay. No, I think he'd know that two mortars, knowing that two mortars is a lot, that's what he'll do on his turn. Focus action for... Since we're all together. One action, hopefully. Oh, dear. Okay. Not that great, but I got one more. No explodey. All right. Power level for stunned is, what is that, a 4?
It's a 4.
Ugh. Do you have any retroactive legend point spending?
It's a one shot. It's a one shot. Why not?
So I'm at 12. I'm at 14. I'll spend. What do I get? I'll spend a legend point.
All right. Let me see.
I'll give you one of my legend points so you can spend 2 legend points.
All right.
All right.
The D20 was very bad.
Yeah. Roll the, you may re-roll the d20, or you may choose to redo the lowest of the attribute dice.
Okay.
The two lowest of the attribute dice, now 2 have been spent.
Yeah, okay. No, I'll go with the d20, I think makes sense. Versus the chance to explode. Yeah, it was a 2.
You get 2 again?
It was a little better.
4.
But you get plus 2.
9, 16. 4 so plus 18. 2. 18 is power level 4. I just made it.
Yeah? Yay.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
All right. You got rid of one of his rounds of stuff. Now, if he shoots again, he's going to stack it back on again, but...
Yes.
No, right. Yeah, yeah. You know.
I really got to do something about this gun. What a mess.
I'm just, like, throwing things out and, like, trying to... Like, he's hemorrhaging oil.
There's probably steam coming out.
Yeah, because they overheat, remember?
Yes.
I think there's probably a risk that he's going to revert to Mr. Handy here, too.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Oh, that's hilarious. All right. Well,
that'd be wonderful as the Assaultron gets closer.
Well, I'm going to roll my will next round to see if I revert.
All right. Well, speaking of... It is the answer's turn.
All right, let's roll will. What do you think I need to, what's my target you think to not revert?
Well, he got rid of one of the stuns.
Right.
So we'll say 15. It's a nice thing.
All right, and I'm rolling a deep.
I'm going to come back surprised. I used the bathroom as well.
Well, I rolled a 16, so it's probably good he got rid of one of those stuns.
Yeah, it is. All right.
All right, so then how far away is it? I didn't hear how far it had gotten to her before she shot.
It is at 540 now. 540.
Let's see, and I've got 150 range with the Gatling. Mm-hmm. So at disadvantage 2, it would be only 450, so I couldn't quite reach that. But you're saying if it's like outside of that range, I can take disadvantage 5 to try and shoot it?
Disadvantage 3?
Technically, yeah. You can. I let people take up to disadvantage 5. Is how I like to play it.
So you but just you just add doing on with the kids. So I could go to disadvantage 3 and it would be within range.
Yes.
Because that'd be yeah, 450. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll do that. So that'd be a total of disadvantage 1 because I can't do anything but shoot. I wouldn't have my move or my minors.
Okay.
Let's see. Should I do that? Or I could bolster myself for future rounds. Yeah, I think that's what he's going to do. He's going to attempt to bolster himself. So he's going to go into his subroutines and get him kicking into high gear so that in the next round. So, let's see, I can only get power level 3.
All right.
That's the wrong dice. That sucks too because I exploded on the D8, but I'm supposed to roll a D10.
Oh.
Yeah, I know the feeling. That happened earlier. Because D12s don't exist.
Yeah. Well, I got 18, so I got power level 3. So, yeah, I bolster myself, bolster my might for one additional advantage. So the next round, I can utilize that.
Okay. All right, then.
And then the stun would be removed.
Okay. All right, that is the answer's turn then. Wendy, you going to take another pot shot? It's at 540 now.
Why not? I guess.
Yeah, what's the worst that could happen?
Be fine. So am I at disadvantage 4 now, or is it still 5? It's 150.
Last time you had to take 5, you would be at disadvantage 4 because the range increment came up.
Okay. And I'm not going to use a legend point this time, but I'm still focus actioning battle tranced stuff.
Attack specialization. So attack you're at disadvantage 1.
Okay. It's not bad. Be fine.
Sure.
Oh, she lost an explodey. I would have gotten explodey.
Oh, well. That was okay. 18.
Mm-hmm. You hear it, the sound of the tink this time is a much more dull kind of tunk, and you can tell, didn't get a good hit this time. So,
It's okay.
But, see, you know, she's still rolling, better than she rolls as ink.
I know.
All those explodies.
I know. What is up with this?
Maybe it's Ingrid and Aurora that's cursed, and it's not her and her
dice. Think Aurora's going to do better.
We'll see.
Oh, sneaky. This is a secret center.
Exactly.
All right. Okay, then. Now we are to the Assaultron itself. It is going to move closer.
I did have a question for you.
Yes.
Based on the mortar shots and the damage done, I don't know if that was enough to issue a provoke to the Assaultron.
What was the roll? It was huge, wasn't it?
It was like 33 on the first one and 29 on the second. So 33 was the one that he was included in.
Yes, it is enough.
Okay, so disadvantage 3 if it doesn't include...
That's fine by the Assaultron.
Oh, I'm sure.
So, all right. It is going to shoot at its fellow bot. It's going to shoot at the answer. So, let's see. 2d8. It had to move a little bit closer. I don't guess it actually has to move any closer. So... it's not moving any closer. It is going to take that bolster itself. It got a bolster from there. I'm going to have to re-roll the die. So.
So I think the extra processing power in the Gatling guns would probably trigger in recognizing the threat of this to autonomously activate or attempt to activate resistance.
Okay.
First, because I'm guessing I would recognize what kind of damage this thing does.
Yes, it is energy based.
Okay.
So, it got an explodey on one, but only an 8 on the d20. So, it's 15. 23, 26.
Okay, so with I rolled a 24.
Okay.
Which activates, so I get plus 6 or plus 9, and I'm fatigued afterwards. Let's go for some fun and do the plus 9. So energy surges through his armor, and so his guard this is attacking guard, I'm guessing.
Yes, it would be guard. So
it goes from a 23 to a 32 guard versus the energy attack.
So as that shielding would kind of come up, the installed, I guess, kind of Tesla portions of whatever additions have been made and modifications have been made to the Sentry Bot.
Right.
Kind of surges up, and the beam hits hard and deflects, and it has that whole DBZ type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, that beam is deflected, and the focus in the eye comes down. So, this thing is apparently able to shoot from there, and is not very pleased with you guys. But currently focusing on Buddy.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you see, definitely the Eternals are starting to heat up from activating this shield of Colton.
Okay.
Oh, man.
All right. Wendy.
Oh, okay. Oh,
is it Colton's turn?
Oh, wait, no, you're right. It's Dodger and Colton.
The boys at the end. You know what?
There's no damage yet for me heating up, but there are probably going to be consequences afterwards.
Got it. Okay, so Dodger. Too many tabs. Double checking. Yes. No, he can't. Okay. Just checking. His Oh, that's interesting. Okay. No, he's got barrier up. He's just going to... I don't think he can even reach. Dodger is gonna have to... He's just gonna prepare an attack for when the robot gets in range. Because he can't do much else. So he'll have an attack.
Right now, it has an advance, though, right?
It advanced to its laser's range. It hasn't advanced yet again.
Yeah. So he'll just be sustaining the barrier, and as soon as the robot gets in range, he'll attack with his energy. And Colton is going to jump down. He's like, all right, hang on, big buddy. I'll take care of you in just a second. We're going to need a little help on this, I think. And he's going to do summon creature.
Nice.
And try and pull up.
I was wondering when you're going to pull that out.
Yeah. So he has advantage 4. He's going to summon 2, I think. Disadvantage 2 for each additional. No. He's going to summon... Yeah, he's going to summon 2. So he has advantage 2 plus a focus action on that. All right. There we go. 19 on the big guy. Just checking the last roll. Okay. 14, 24, so 36, so he succeeds. So he's going to quick pull out of the wagon and plug in their power sources, these two little, like, spider-ish robotic creatures, and throw them out there to be next to Wendy. And that's, so they're at power level 6, so I got 2 little guys. They'll act on my next turn. And that's his turn.
Okay. All right. That means we are back to the top with the answer.
All right. Yeah, I'm going to move forward 30 feet.
Okay.
Now that I'm no longer stunned. So I got my movement. So now he's like, what, 5'10"?
Yes.
So I still need to take disadvantage 3 to reach him. All right. And let's see. I'm currently bolstering myself. And I've got superior concentration, so I'm also maintaining the resistance. So I got advantage 3, so I'm just a flat roll.
All right.
Not great on the attribute dice, but a 17 on that one, so that's a total of 20.
Total of 20. Straight attack against
tough. Yeah, it'd be guard, because this is the Gatling.
All right. You know that you're doing a little damage, but not that shot probably was a bit off. A bit off.
The little outside the lethal range.
Yeah. All right. So now, Wendy, what you doing?
Okay. I don't think I'm gonna move. I think I'm good. I'm just gonna take another shot.
All right.
This is the most epic villain approach. Just trying to take it off. Oh man, I just throw everything at it.
I'm only at disadvantage 1 now, or?
It didn't move.
It didn't move.
You haven't moved, and it hasn't moved any closer to you.
So disadvantage.
So it's 1. Still a minus. It's 4.
4 total. She has 3 advantage from
okay
feats and focus action.
Okay. Oh,
Oh man, losing that exploding.
I lost another 10, but I still did really good.
You did.
Hold on. Yeah.
27.
27. I know.
Okay, sorry.
I was just second guessing myself.
All right. So, 27. You definitely hit it this time. You get a better shot this time. So you've smacked into, we'll say you smacked a knee, but it didn't quite take the cap off.
Ah.
But you got some.
Yes, because Darlene has, what does she have? Potent on that, right? Darlene.
Yes, 5 over, she automatically does immobile, and it is potent.
Forgot to say that.
Oh, okay.
Because it's late later.
What was the result again?
27.
Oh, guess what? Yeah.
Yay!
Ankle biter lives up to her name. So, just like in the game, we'll play, for time's sake, we'll play it just like in the game. As it pop, you knock off one of the legs, it looks around and is kind of stuck there. Programming going wrong. Yeah. So it is currently immobile on the ground at the mercy of y'all, and it's, that means it has to skip its turn. So,
no
Kristen,
way.
Just like,
oh man,
there you go. All right,
yeah, Darlene.
So, Dodger, Colton, what's happening now? It's still 540 feet away, but from you,
I'm not feeling that epic.
Send those spiders out.
Yeah, I mean, I might as well see what happens. I'll have. I was gonna check real.
I mean, the answer is clearly going to keep moving forward.
Yeah.
I'm Dodgers tempted to do the, the bombardment again.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it stopped moving.
The spiders will follow the answer. Yeah, it's so far away. They can't do anything, so they're going to follow the answer with their movement. Dodger's gonna stay near Wendy. He keeps Wendy safe, so.
You know, Dan, I was thinking it would have been really good if your allergies were messing up tonight.
Yeah,
then
right.
You would have sounded just right.
Yeah.
Just perfect.
Yeah.
Colton will, on his turn, sustain the summoned creature. There it is. Yeah. Now I can do that as a free action with Boon Focus 3, so he's going to try to throw up. No, maybe he should heal. He's going to try and do rest. Can I do restoration to help with whatever's the overheating issue is? For
it doesn't happen until I stop sustaining.
Okay.
Okay. So as soon as I stop sustaining resistance, I get hit with fatigue.
Gotcha. Okay. Then I'll stick with, he'll try to do a bolster on the answer. All right. Yeah, 19 on the d20. 11, so that's a 30 total. So, power level 6 bolster.
Nice.
All right. So perhaps these bots are kind of actually climbing on top of and around the answer, trying to do quick fixes.
Oh, I like
on
that.
His stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okie dokie. All right, we're back up to the answer.
Yeah, I'm going to move 30 feet forward.
All right.
Am I, though?
Uh-oh.
I could just mortar it.
It's not going anywhere.
Nope, just like in the games.
No, I know. It works so well.
That was
such a good strategy.
Yeah.
All right. I'll roll a d20. On 11 and higher, what do you think it should be, Dan? Do I mortar it at 11 higher, or do I gatling it at 11 or higher?
I think mortar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Biggest boom, you know?
Got a 12.
Oh my goodness.
So I'm not going to move forward. Which means I'll immediately be fatigued because I'll be stunned afterwards. Well, I guess I could technically attempt to maintain it, but Yeah, so I'll do the mortar shot. So I don't have any disadvantage, but I'm bolstered too, so that's an advantage 5 to this shot.
Okay.
All right.
I love that image of the spider creatures. Like, there's little, they're like welding pieces back together.
It's rattling off. They're tightening it down.
I like the idea that as he stops, suddenly one falls off and then has to like do a roll and run back and climb on.
All right, so we're at a 30.
Nice.
Now okay. The D8 exploded.
Yeah.
All right. Get high enough and it's instant.
That is a 37.
37.
All now, right. I did put that the range of bombardment could, in theory, be toughness because it's an area blast, but I don't know whichever one makes more sense to you, guard or toughness.
Well, it matters little at the moment because and Colton, why don't you roll me let me see, I guess perception. Roll me a perception roll to see just how much of this is actually going to be salvageable after that blast.
Yeah. A 7, so
be fine.
Looks great.
Not a lot. Yeah. I mean, the head seems to be where all the focal point was. So, unfortunately, there's not going to be an Assault-tron head upgrade in the future for right now. But the legs, aside from a kneecap, you know, aside from being capped off one of them, you know, those are repairable. It's almost like the blast was centered on the head for some reason, like it was heat guided or something like that. So
yeah, and the answer would, of course, it would be stunned and fatigued level 1. It would continue to move forward after that to get closer to the other two that were fallen as well, to make sure they're not moving.
They're still trying to move. They've been crawling away. This
don't kill them. Tease off.
Going to acquire the unwelcome guests.
No. They need to try the tea. The tea's good, right? Is that what
we
say?
No, the tea's off.
The tea's off?
Yeah, we're not having tea.
We're not having tea. No. No.
He's already driving off.
He does have to be within range for vocal commands, I suppose.
Yeah.
He's got to be able to hear you.
We're going to run behind, trying to catch up. Yeah.
Hold on, we need to know. Right. Where
eventually, when he gets
from.
There, he's just going to put both Gatlings like at their heads and command them to, you know, tell them everything.
It's along the lines of a don't kill me, please don't kill me. It's just a job. It's don't kill me, please don't kill me. That's usually that's kind of what comes out. but if y'all want to make some rolls to get some information from them. There's a strong case for intimidation right there. So,
yeah, I think I'm helping, assisting with. Well, I've got 4 in presence, so I don't know what anybody else wants to use, but I'd probably assist somebody.
Yeah, I think we're both 3s.
Mm-hmm.
Then,
all right, so you want to assist me, I guess?
Yeah, let's do that. Mm-hmm. Dodger will definitely come up and be like, growling through his speaker.
Hold up. Darling. Like, who hired you?
All right. Okay, so what were all the rolls then?
Do we have to
do
roll?
Do you want to start the roll?
Are we just bolstering?
Or assisting?
Oh, my God.
Oh boy.
I assumed you were assisting. So.
44 because of the assistance. I exploded twice on the D10.
Oh,
all right.
Well, at first they've been beat up, and it was much more along the lines of, please don't kill me. Oh, I don't want to die. You know, I've got a wife and 8 kids, and sometimes it's a wife and 5 kids, you know, all that type of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But eventually, after they're done pissing themselves and stuff, you get the idea that they were hired, and they were hired specifically for this purpose, this job, and it was someone associated with the fort, which is way over at A. It's on the other side.
Oh.
And the fort is run by somebody, by a single guy who's the mayor of the fort. But they're not very clear. They're not really sure who it was at the fort. But it was somebody who helps either run the fort or actually runs the fort. So somebody involved with the government in the fort is wanting to intercept this package you were carrying. Apparently enough to hire an Assaultron assault team. So.
Spending the big bucks.
Yeah. Well.
I don't want this package anymore.
Let's just get it to its destination.
Yeah.
First, let's pick their pockets.
Yep.
And see if they can crawl their way back.
The wasteland.
The answer has gone over to the Assaultron is like poking it, going, "Who's better now?"
So we'll let them crawl all their right way back. If they live, they live.
Yep.
All right. Well, not just for time's sake, but in general, the rest of the little jaunt is uneventful. You are able to make it safely up Mazzard 222, which is Rogers, and go down Rogers and get to the bar. And upon arriving, because we're kind of long. You Stacys are in the wrong time zone, you know. So,
I know.
For story wrap up, you guys get there and welcomed back. You guys have long been trusted to run back and forth with stuff and things like that. And you're glad to be back with with this drop off, especially. Mm. When you do drop it off, they say,
"Oh yeah, and they wanted you to deliver it personal if you would up to the 13 themselves. One of them died recently."
Okay. Let's do it. I guess.
All right.
Got to deliver. It's probably the job.
Yeah, let's just get rid of this thing. Yeah. All right.
All right. So it's not. That it's pretty safe, but it is very safe for a ghoul between the bar and the damn 13. So it's basically just delivery then. When you get there, not many people go in to see the 13 because of just how heavily radiated it is.
Mm.
Everything around the damned 13 glows around that lock and dam, and I say everything, most everything glows with radiation, because as the radiation has worked through and down the Arkansas River to that point, it is built up there until this huge forest of mushrooms has grown, mushrooms upon mushrooms, and you guys have cut your way. There's a road cut through there that leads in. And there, on the dam, sit the damned 13 themselves, with one missing. And they sit on, basically, mushrooms themselves, mushrooms that are high above things. And they say, they say, you think together, but it sounds like one voice. Thank you. We were waiting for the 13th. Please, if you would, open the crates.
Okay. I don't know what's gonna happen. Jam the pry bar in and kick it open.
Alright. So you open both the crates. There's the tech in there and stuff like that. But some of the attendants, the ghoulish attendants, that are below their mushroom thrones, I guess, they lift, kind of toss that stuff to the side. This is expensive equipment. They just toss it to the side. And they lift up something that looks like, it looks like an artillery case. And as they open it and bring it, as they bring it out, it is a lead box. And it looks like it probably held, well, it's metal box, and it looks like it held a long set of maybe huge Gatling stuff from the Great War. They pop it open, and out comes a ghoul. A glowing one. And they say, welcome, brother, new 13th.
I thought it was gonna be one of us. Ooh. Yeah, me too. Oh, thank goodness.
I thought about presenting y'all with that delete, but I decided against it for the one-shot's sake. So
that would be good.
The answer would become one of the.
Yes.
The answer decides to be one of the final 13th. Not sure how that would work. But you successfully delivered the next 13th damned. And
always been my lucky
successfully
number.
Done so. Successfully doing so, you now have pretty much the bar at your disposal for trading, which is why you've gone from one wealth level up by, you've gone up two wealth levels. Because of that successful delivery, you have the great favors that can be called in from the damned 13.
Nice.
That's awesome.
All right. And that is what we've got. That's what I've got for y'all.
For that's the one shot.
Nice. That was fun.
Thank you. Awesome.
Yeah, we rolled pretty well. This
is really... I mean, I rolled bad, but that's okay. I'm the support character.
Yeah, that was some good rolls for as much disadvantage you had.
We did it. That was awesome. Yeah. And it was like, picking that street was just right for a mortar and a sharpshooter.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That's great. Awesome.
Love some fallout.
Yes. The reason we're laughing, Legbiter is what I jokingly call Kristen, yes, because she loves fallout and that's what she'd do.
Yeah, because I didn't like the creepy ghouls getting too close, so I'd shoot their legs out so that they couldn't get near me.
Literally be like 10 around her and they're all still alive, they're but all they just don't like, have legs, so they're just standing there doing that. So anyways, yeah, that's the inside joke on that. Thank you guys for doing this. Thank you, Adam, from Inn Of Planar Crossroads. Great Moustache, owner and operator of Open Legends. This is amazing. It's right back there.
Wait, by the way.
Lean away. Yeah, there it is. Right in the back. OpenLegendRPG.com, where the core rule book is all on there for free. Of course, the actual book is amazing. You can use the code Bomb Squad, which is our pilot show that's still running, comes out mostly Fridays, mostly. Friday nights. If you use the code Bomb Squad in the Open Legend store, you get 10% off. There's some cool stuff. Is the GM screen on there now, or is that still just going to
the GM screen's on there.
Okay. awesome new GM screen on
there. Yeah, it's for sale. All backers, all the original Kickstarter backers have had theirs shipped.
Perfect.
Good.
And from what I know, everybody's received theirs, but.
Yeah.
At least everybody that responded.
Fair enough. So I highly recommend it. The art's amazing. Book's great. Amora's Dawn, the campaign setting they made, is actually behind there. So check that out again. 10% off with the Bomb Squad coupon code. Of course, check out Adam's channel, Inn Of Planar Crossroads, for more RPG content. We'll be recording an Around the Hearth sooner than not, as mentioned before. And again, October 29th. We will be doing our special movie night where Adam will be here in person. We're going to have several people there in the garage studio. We'll probably try to do a live stream at the beginning for a little bit just to show you what the movie nights are. And then we'll kick out the public and it'll just be for the Forest family, all of our supporters, and us as we watch Over the Garden Wall. Thank you guys so much for tuning into the adventure. This has been another fantastical episode of the AV Epics live stream with Adam from the Inn Of Planar Crossroads and Great Moustache. And thank you for dealing with me still learning how to figure this out, this live streaming thing. But I think it went pretty well.
Technology is always a pleasure to deal with.
Yep. Yeah. We might do another test live stream coming up where I try out Prism, which is a new live streaming system, so we'll see if we play around with that. But last announcement before we go, next Wednesday we're back with Jacob and Compass and Chiro Chiba doing the Pathfinder 2e Outlaws of Elkenstar. So that'll be next Wednesday. Not sure what we'll do on the Wednesday after that, but every other Wednesday is the Pathfinder 2e game.
I would like to do VR.
VR.
Live we have stream, been talking about doing that. Scary games.
Yep.
That's what I want to do.
We may set that up. We'll see if we can make that happen. So anyways, thank you guys so much for joining the adventure. And we will see you next time. Mar bye. I'm too slow. Now Mar bye.